Congratulations, your CNC router is now ready to mill. Let me give you a quick startup guide on the machine. First, turn on the main power switch. You should see all the limit switches lighting up. This indicates that they are functional and that the machine is safe to use. After a few seconds, the Raspberry Pi will load a desktop interface. The software we're going to use to control the machine is called Planet CNC. There's a shortcut on the desktop. Let's open it right away. In this video, I will only show you basic features of the software. You can refer to the documentation you received to learn more about it. When you turn on the machine, the first thing you have to do is called a homing procedure. This allows the machine to locate itself in the 3D space. Simply click on this button to start the procedure. If one of the axes is moving in the wrong direction when you jog, don't panic. Simply go to the File Settings menu. This is where you can change the driving direction of each motor. Simply go to the motor section and check the radio button Reverse for the relevant axis. You can now safely move the machine using the jog interface from Planet CNC. Next, you need to attach the end mill to the spindle. To unscrew the mandrel, you have to lock it using the press button located at the back of the spindle. Then use the wrench you received to unscrew it. You can now insert the end mill inside the collets and screw the mandrel back in place. In order for the machine to know the coordinate zero of the vertical axis, it needs to know the length of the mill we just mounted. To achieve this, we need to use the probe device. This one is composed of this crocodile clip that we need to attach to the end mill, and of this metallic surface you need to put on top of the working surface. Click now on this button and let the machine do the work. It is now time to attach the workpiece to the spoiler board. If you aren't familiar with CNC machines yet, we recommend you use a simple wooden panel on which you can attach a workpiece with wood screws. While attaching the workpiece, make sure that it is aligned with your machine. This system provides a very cheap and quick clamping method, easy to replace and allowing you to make mistakes without damaging an expensive work table. Now that the piece is firmly attached to the spoiler board, let's open our first G-code. Take the USB key you received with your kit and plug it in the control box. A pop-up window should appear on your screen. Open the folder named Software and simply drag and drop the G-code file to your desktop. Click on the top left button and select the G-code file to open it. You will see the toolpath in the graphical interface of Planet CNC, which corresponds to the G-code you just loaded, visible on the right side of the screen. Now we have to set the correct working coordinates, corresponding to the physical location of your workpiece. Machine's coordinates represent the absolute coordinates of your tool, relative to the machine origin. They were defined when we did the home procedure earlier. To define the working coordinates, move your machine to the origin of your workpiece using the jog. You have to position the center of your tool exactly above the front left corner of your wood piece. You can reduce the jog speed by clicking on it and changing its value to be more accurate. Use the small arrows to move by 0.1 mm steps if you want to be extra precise. When you're done, simply click on the Work Position 0 button. The X and Y working coordinates will be set to 0, and the position of the virtual toolpath will now correspond to the physical location of your workpiece. Before we can start, we have to set the correct rotational speed on the router. Turn the wheel until you reach the digit 4, corresponding to 17,000 RPM. Oh, and don't forget to turn on the router. You can now start the program by clicking on the play icon. If you don't want to have wooden chips everywhere, grab a vacuum cleaner to clean the piece while it's being machined. Even better, you can install the dust shoe you received in your kit to keep a clean machine with little effort. When the program is finished, click on the stop icon to unlock the machine. Move away from the workpiece using the jog. Close Planet CNC and don't forget to shut down your Raspberry Pi when you're finished working on the machine. Turning off the control box without a software shutdown might corrupt the Raspberry Pi memory. This was a very short presentation of our CNC router, but if you want to go deeper on the understanding of this machine and how to mill correctly, go check our online tutorials.